And turning to weather, look at this. The middle of the U.S. has a big mess to clean up. Ice has left nearly 500,000 people without power in Oklahoma alone. At least 18 people have died in this huge storm that now stretches from Oklahoma all the way to New York.
And there's more bad news. It's not over yet. Ice and winter storm warnings have been issued through Missouri, Kansas, Iowa, Nebraska, and Illinois for today. It's also had a major impact on flights throughout the country. About 100 flights were canceled at Chicago's O'Hare Airport. You're looking at live flight information out of Orlando right now. We know that there have been major delays yesterday and today at Chicago's O'Hare. You can find this page anytime on WESH.com.
Well, and that's not a fun airport to fly into or out of when
on a normal
there
day.
Are no weather problems.
Exactly. Yeah.
And we've got Olga churning out there. How do our weather conditions here look, though? Forgetting about what's out there in the tropics and forgetting about all this other bad weather.
Yeah.
We look pretty good.
No, it's not that bad. Yeah. I mean, we can't complain a whole lot, guys. This morning we have the warmth and going to be seeing those temperatures well above average once again, but very little consequence. Let's take a look now at what's going on out there with the headlines, because we do have the morning fog still around, especially Marion County. That's where we're seeing the worst of it. This pattern is going to continue for the week with the morning fog and the warm afternoon temperatures. We do have a strong cold front showing up as we head in toward the weekend. I'll have more on that coming up in your 7-day forecast shortly, but it does look like a stronger front on the way. Right now, the low visibility, Leesburg up to Ocala as usual, even Sanford dropping down, especially north and west of I-4. That's where the worst of it is this morning. Low to mid-60s out there, except 73 at Melbourne. Already a very warm and balmy start for this time of the year. Onshore flow, so we do have a little isolated shower trying to come into Brevard County from time to time, but radar returns dissipating now. So not much rain out there at all. It's going to be a mainly dry day. Here's a look at subtropical storm Olga moving off to the west of San Juan, Puerto Rico now, and it's heading westward. I'll have more on that coming up. But here are your highs today. Low 80s to even some 83s mixing in around Orlando and Kissimmee, right around 81 at Melbourne today. Now here again is Olga moving westward at 17. It's about 65 miles away from San Juan there, moving toward the Dominican Republic. So later on tonight or tomorrow, it's expected to weaken into just a depression and be a remnant low into the Western Caribbean by the end of the week. So something to watch in the days to come, but it's really a flood threat for the Dominican Republic and Haiti coming up overnight tonight and into tomorrow. We're talking about 4 to 6 inches of rain, even isolated amounts up to 10 inches possible over Hispaniola. All right, now into the west we go. Look at this ice, really from about Chicago back in toward Oklahoma. Rain off to the south, snow off to the north. Big storm here. Meanwhile, high pressure is keeping us quiet, and it's also keeping Olga off to our south, so we're not worried about Olga coming our way. This high is going to keep us protected. It's also going to keep that onshore flow going. It's going to keep us on the warmer and more humid side of average right on through the week, and then we're tracking that stronger front as we head in toward the weekend. But that's the pattern that we're in, just kind of warm in the afternoon with the overnight fog, and then we're back to it again on Wednesday. Can't rule out again a stray shower off the Atlantic, but that flow coming on shore not very strong, so it doesn't look like a great chance of rain until Saturday. That's when the front gets here. That's when the rainfall ramps up, and look at the highs on Sunday and look at the lows on Sunday night, 60s and 40s.